So today I thought I'd give you a little walkthrough of what's going on so far. I kind of show you this from the beginning to the planting stage, and then just kind of go through a walkthrough. So we'll go back here first. You can see the chickens out doing their thing. Back here is my small greenhouse, and then this is our big compost pile, and you can see there's lots of weeds in it on the top. You can see how good the soil is by just the size of this plant. And this is a dandelion, if I'm correct. Yeah, I think it's a big dandelion. There's another one over there. There's wild carrot back there. We have wild carrots all over the neighborhood. Down there is some lettuce that I threw last year. I've been feeding it to the chickens because it's really bitter. So this is where it starts. You can see I come over here and dig it up and go through it. Take out the rocks and the twigs and stuff. But this has been really good soil for me this year. It's my second year with this compost pile. It's my first year using it. I just let it sit here for 2 years, break down, decompose all the sticks and stuff. And then I use that for my seedlings. So we'll go in the small greenhouse. And I've been taking stuff out of here today and planting it, but down here I have some onions that are finally coming up. I didn't think these were going to come up at all. These are 2 or 3 year old onion seeds, and I just kind of threw them in here to see if they'd work. And there's some scallions and some leeks and some onions, and they're starting to come up, but I don't know if we'll get any kind of big production out of them. Just going to kind of use them because I had them and use up the seeds. Over here I have cilantro and collard greens, I think, or kohlrabi. Yeah, it's kohlrabi, which when you grow kohlrabi, you want it for the bulbs. A lot of times I use it just, I just grow the greens and use the greens in salads. Those will both get planted out today. Up here is arugula, or rocket, or those in the UK. One of my favorite greens. It's a really peppery, really good, and this grows like a weed. But this, I might plant this today, or I might wait a little bit just until it gets a little bigger. Nothing on this side because I've got it out planting right now. You see Red, she's our lone chicken. She was the one that was getting bullied by all the rest of the chickens, and she's super healthy and really, really calm and different. Changed her demeanor and everything from the way she was before, kind of scattered brained and running around like a nutcase. But you're good now, huh, Red? I'll take you to the big greenhouse. And the big greenhouse is where I do most of the propagation for all of our seeds. And then if it's something cooler, I'll take it back to the smaller greenhouse, because right now in spring, it's cooler back there than it is in the big greenhouse. Whatever it is in the big greenhouse, it's about 20 degrees cooler back there. So in here you can see my mess of plants. I've got, in this hanging basket, I think there's more weeds than there's actual flowers, but there's marigolds planted in there. There's some tomato plants down here. Lots of tomatoes. Cucumbers. We've got Roma tomatoes. Those ones are going to go to market. These are golden sunburst tomatoes, patio snacker, and bush cucumbers. These will be grown for the fruit for market. Those Romas are actually, I'll wait till those get a little bigger and then sell the plants at market. These are sweet million tomatoes. If you've seen online what's called the, what's the name of it? Rapunzel, cherry tomatoes. The sweet million is the same thing. Comfrey is in the back. These are Manitoba and cherry bomb tomatoes. Bonnie's Best tomatoes. These are apple seeds that I grew. Gala apples, I think it is. There's some chard I need to get out today. Down on the shelf is some more endive, which I'll be selling at market, just the plants. I don't remember what I grew in here. I think these were... I think they're cucumber seeds, but I'm not sure, but they need to get out in the sun, obviously. Down here, what do I have? Collard greens, so these need to get out. There's a carrot seed that I dropped, apparently, a couple of them that are growing down there. There's breen, which is a romaine lettuce. I've got a bunch of that planted out. That needs to go out today. These are more tomatoes. Echinacea, which I just planted a couple days ago. Those are all cucumber seeds that will be grown for market, for plants for market. There's marigolds and weeds down there. What did I grow here? Oh, more tomatoes that I just planted out. This is more breen. I believe that's kale. Well, I planted a little bit of kale this year because I didn't have good luck with it last year. Along the middle table is just more tomatoes, home slice, 42-day big league. I can't read what that one says because the markers kind of run. These are Thai hot peppers, which will take a while for those to come out because it's just so... it hasn't just been that super hot yet. These are violet jaspers. Something grand. I don't remember what that one was. More tomatoes. The butcher tomato. Oregon spring. Early choice. Can't read what that other variety is. I've got them all written down, but this is all tomatoes. Over here on the side. More tomatoes, early dell, red cherry, sugary, pulbig, red pear. I've been growing yellow pear for years, really like them. And the red pear is an heirloom variety that I never saw in a catalog before, and I saw it this year, so I decided to try it. Zucchini, cucumber, mountain fresh, early fire, and seedless tomatoes, early blue, and... I don't know if the other one is in the back here, so I can't read it. These are 8-ball zucchini. So these are, they're like the size of a 8-ball pool cue. Pool ball, not cue. So they're not long, they're balls from zucchini. And I tried to grow them one year, probably 3 or 4 years ago, and I didn't have any luck with them, but these seeds seem to be doing really good. What else do I have along here? These are some tomato grow bags that I got this year I'm going to try. And these all have like cherry tomatoes in them. I think there's a Roma down in the middle. The bumblebee, pink bumblebee tomatoes down there. This is the calabash. So just kind of trying some different things. Last year I grew the violet jaspers in here. And I think I'm going to grow those outside this year. So we go from... back where I showed you the compost pile, it's in here to seeding all these with seeds. There's a big container of seeds down here, if you can see it. These are all my seeds. And there's some up here. These are like new ones that I'm trying to get through and get all those potted up and seeded. Over here, we tried some lavender. Which now it takes forever for lavender seed to germinate, so it's looking more like weeds than lavender. So I'll just try it again and see what happens. And there's some little tomato plants. Microtoms is what those are. And then I will show you what's going on outdoors. So in here I've just got some peas in this little raised bed. I've got a bunch more peas out front and some greens. That's our new outside table. Hooks up to the hose, and then I can come out. I can just wash everything out here. I don't take everything inside and get it dirty. There's a bunch of garlic down there. My tomato grow bag from last year. It's a mess outside right now because obviously I'm still trying to get everything in order for the year. So here's our first bed that I've been working with. Still trying to fill this one. I've got two more beds here that are pretty much done, and then there'll be there'll be six beds here total that go from the walkway all the way to the fence. And in here we've got broccoli rapini, or broccoli rob as it's known in some places. Bok choy and pai sai, which is basically just another kind of bok choy. If you can see those little bits down there, those are bream. That's that romaine type lettuce. There's sorrel, endive, there's beetroot. What else do we have in here? Cabbage plants, spinach, mustard greens. I think there's more endive or chicory. I think that one's chicory there. Today I'm planting Rosalita lettuce, which is a head lettuce. And you can see here, this is the square foot planting, and I just used 12-inch sticks that I make. And so within that little area there, that little 4-foot space, I've got 16 lettuce plants. Over there's some chard. There's onions I just stuck in here. This middle bed will be beans, which I started the other day, and then ended up starting to rain, so I stopped working on it. But I've got some onions and some beans in here, but this entire bed will be, it'll be a good majority of beans through here. Just bush beans, not climbing beans. Over here you can see our bamboo and pond, and the bamboo this year has just gone crazy. I mean, this is where I planted it, obviously. See my little gnome hiding in there. And then if you come out a little bit from where the plant base is, this is one stalk that came up this year. And here's another one, quite a distance away from the original plant. And then here's another smaller one over here. So, I mean, it carries pretty far, and there's lots more popping up. There's another one, and just quite a few more that are coming up. So it's a really healthy plant, and the stems are getting thicker, which is what I need, so I can start harvesting it and using the canes to build stuff. That was the whole purpose of us getting this. This is a green bamboo, which grows in cooler temperatures. So the first year I had it, these are still on here, and I need to trim these this year. But you can see this, there's a few stems here that are dead, and that first year those died, and leaves never came back on them, so I need to take those off. But after that first year, it's just gone crazy, and the leaves even stay in the winter. So I've had really good luck with this. You see there's some popping up here, there's more popping up over here by the pond. So just a crazy amount of new growth on the bamboo. Some onions sporadically around here from last year that obviously I didn't harvest. Our asparagus, I don't think we're going to get to eat any this year. I mean, I might pick it, and we might just eat it like it is, but I don't know. This is a third year, and it didn't get really big. It died off, though. We had a week of really bad cold, and it died off. So, you know, I mean, maybe that might have been it for this year. This is garlic, which is doing really well. Planted this in October, so we should be harvesting this relatively soon. And then here's all the potatoes so far this year. And I think that's about it, really. Just kind of wanted to give a little update about what we've been doing. Yesterday was our first day back at market for the year, which was a lot of fun. I made homemade bread, made 3 loaves of that, which sold in about an hour. So I guess I'm gonna have to make a bunch more for next week. we sold some of Sam Ree's spice mixes. That was pretty much it. One of her crocheted crafts. But it was a good day. And really ambitious this year, but what I want to grow. I'd like to grow at least 100 tomato plants. And, you know, I bought 36 varieties of seed, which is a little bit nuts. But I'm hoping to get all this done relatively soon. All these beds, get stuff planted out. I can take you in the back and show you the fruit trees while we talk. Yeah, I mean, this year I want to get a lot more stuff planted and do a lot more. I need to add like 5 more raised beds in the front. I've got those Well, the one is completely planted with peas, and then the other two are half planted with greens. So I like to have some greens for market. Back here by the garage is some beans I threw in just as an experiment from a couple years ago, and some of them are coming up, and then those are radishes over there. That's a pawpaw tree, real small, and there's another real small one down there. So we'll grow those for the chickens, but of course it'll be many years before those actually produce any fruit. This is our plum tree. It has just gone absolutely crazy this year. This is, I want to say, the 60th year we've had this. We've never got any fruit off of it as early and as big as it's got just this year. I'm hoping we get some fruit off of it. Last year I got one cherry off my cherry tree, but it is doing very well this year. One of our pear trees is doing really well. This pear tree is not. This is the nectarine and peach tree, or no, they're both peach trees. These both got peach borers last year. I cut them back a lot. I don't know if they're even gonna make it. If they don't, that really sucks, because those were like $30 trees. But I mean, sometimes things happen. That's just part of growing and learning, you know. So if these three don't make it, I'll probably end up, you know, buying something different and trying something else. You can see strawberry plants throughout here. They're really starting to come up. Last year they were attacked by rabbits. I don't know if it's going to happen again this year. Some more onions from last year. There's some lettuce from last year. Just, I've kind of just let the backyard by the orchard just grow, because I've just got too much other stuff to do. Eventually, you know, I'd like to have this planted with the stuff that's beneficial. This year I'm going to plant a bunch of beans back here to help the fruit trees. I did last year, but not as many as I'd like to this year. The strawberries, I just want those to just keep going wherever they want. This little plant here, we just found out, is wild mustard garlic, or garlic mustard green. It's really good. It's basically a weed. But it is part of like the collard family, and it's really good. Somebody told Sammy it was in season, and so I walked around and I was like, oh, this must be it from the picture. And the big leaves have like this really strong garlic flavor, but really good. So I'm gonna wait for that to go to seed, and then I'm gonna grow it, because obviously it's a native here. So I think that's about it now. Hope you enjoyed the little walkthrough, and I'll try to keep doing these now that I have more time and I'm not worrying about getting the market done. I spent the last couple months really making sure the market was ready to open yesterday, so I'm not, I don't know what the word is, like, I'm not so concerned about it now because we're open, so now I can just take it easy a little bit and work on the farm here. So, until next time, have a great day.